If you have one of these iPhones with a camera array, very similar to like the latest generation, the iPhone 12 Pro, continue watching this video. So I'm gonna go ahead and go through some awesome features and some nifty effects that you could create with this camera array. And some nifty tricks you could do with that little LiDAR sensor that not a lot of people know about, and I'm surprised Apple didn't advertise this during their keynote. And yes, it doesn't matter if you have the non-pro version of the iPhone. As long as you have a dual camera setup, you can follow some of these nifty tricks. So we should be fairly familiar with the camera app of the iPhones. When you launch it, you can select between the different lens right here by tapping on the numbers. But a cool trick that you could also do is not just the little rotating wheel thing right here to get the exact zoom that you're looking for, but while doing this effect, and if you lock on to a target, which you could also lock the exposure by simply tapping on the screen and it's sliding your finger up and down like so, leave it, it'll stay locked in. And while you step away from the subject, at the same time, if you click on the little zoom wheel, if you move it towards the opposite direction that you're walking towards the subject, you could create this really cool looking dolly zoom effect on the native app on your iPhone. And it's a really nifty way to get creative. Moving along, this one's exclusive to the iPhone 12 Pro because it now has this cool LiDAR sensor right here. But this little black dot, if you download the measurement app, the official one by Apple, did you know it will actually measure people's height right there on the display in a matter of seconds? It's really trippy how well this actually works. So if you want to quickly see somebody else's height, you could quickly just launch the measurement app. It will not only do an excellent job of measuring like home appliances, posters, and etc., but it can also measure people live even while they're moving. Another nifty feature that I'm sure not a lot of folks know about is the pano mode. In the pano mode, you can actually click on the arrow to switch between the starting side. But in addition to that, you still have access to the other lens as well. So you can switch to the ultra wide to capture a lot more. So you have the freedom to do that. Now, night mode on the iPhone is really cool, but some people don't know about this. If you want to quickly switch to night mode when taking photos, sometimes by default, your flash may be enabled, and this will disable the night mode feature. So to go ahead and enable night mode, just make sure the flash is turned off like so. Make sure it shows you this icon. And then when you're in a dark environment, you'll see this new icon. You can either leave it by default. If you leave it by default, your iPhone will automatically select the amount of exposure that it thinks it needs. But if you have to, you can also extend it by simply sliding the bottom slider just like so. And then if you start moving too much, there's gonna be a crosshair right there. Just try to keep it lined up and steady. And sometimes when you extend the slider on the bottom, you could get creative and create some trippy looking light effects, especially if there's an object in the background moving. Now, in terms of taking selfies, the iPhone 12s and the Pro, the front-facing camera is now a 12-megapixel camera. But a thing that I noticed when you switch the front-facing camera, by tapping this little arrow icon on the bottom, this will quickly switch between the 8-megapixel to the full 12-megapixel. So you can capture a lot more in the front-facing camera whenever you have it like this. But if you switch to landscape mode, by default, it will automatically switch to the full 12 megapixel camera. Besides that, you still have the other settings right here. If you tap the little arrow icon, you can manually select night mode, flash, the live control. You can change the ratio. If you want to make it Instagram ready, you can select this, the exposure levels, and you can add a timer if you want, which will show you the number countdown right there on the bottom. And then while we're still on the subject of front-facing camera side of things, Selfies. Don't forget, this was something that Apple was marketing during the release of the previous generation, the iPhone 11 and the 11 Pro. You can still do that here. You can see the FPS rate right above here. On the front-facing camera, it's locked in at 120 FPS at 1080p. But just by simply hitting record, front-facing camera is on, and this is how you take your Selfies. Now, you can take photos here as well by tapping the little shutter icon. So while you're recording this slow motion video, you can literally just tap right here. It'll take a photo as well in addition to that. And then you can replay it. And I don't know why this is a thing. And really, I'd like to know in the comment section how many of you guys actually successfully were able to utilize this Selfie feature. just out of curiosity. But besides that, if you flip back to the front-facing camera, just like the video tab, here you can select between the different frame rates you want to record. And if you go to the video mode, you can also do the same thing if you want 1080p, 4K, as well as select the different FPS rate right here. But back in the photo mode, by simply tapping the shutter icon, it will take a photo. If you tap and hold, it will begin recording a video. If you slide your finger to the lock icon, it's going to be locked in video mode and won't stop until you hit stop. And that's a quick little nifty shortcut on how to capture video. Portrait mode, nothing has really changed between the previous generation iPhones. You can still capture lighting. If you're using the Pro, you can capture objects. You can do the same with the iPhone 12, but there's only some iPhones that only work with people. I believe the iPhone SE second generation is one of them, where the front-facing camera in portrait mode can only capture people, not objects. But again, studio light, stage light, everything else is identical. So if you're one of the few people that actually use this stuff, it's here. And everything else is exactly the same. So I'm not really gonna highlight as much about portrait mode. Now, in terms of settings to adjust, if we go on our phone and quickly go into the setting application and scroll down where you see camera, here you go select the format. If you're using Apple devices like a MacBook to like back up your photos and files, you could just leave it on high efficiency. But if you're using a Windows laptop or any Windows computer in general to upload your photos and such, I recommend leaving it in most compatible. This just switches the format. But high efficiency will actually compress the files smaller for your iPhone, so it doesn't take up that much storage. And in addition to that, it will still be able to have the same resolution and deliver the same amount of quality as if you left it on most compatible. So I recommend leaving it on high efficiency if your main device is a Mac or something. And then most compatible if your main device is a Windows computer. Stereo recording, leave that on. Now in the preserve setting tab, right here on camera mode, I like to personally leave this on because what this basically allows you to do is, let's say for example, we go back in our camera application and we leave it a video. And then now you close the application, but you want to quickly relaunch it like minutes later. It's gonna take you back where you last left off in the camera setting. So I left it on video, it's gonna stay on video as soon as I relaunch the app. That's basically what it does. This is a personal preference, but I like to leave this on. You could do the same thing with the creative controls as well, as this will actually leave you where you last left off on filters, aspect ratio, light, in-depth settings, rather than automatically having it reset every time you go back in the application. You could do the exact same thing with the exposure adjustment as well. And live photos, you could also enable it here, but you could do the exact same thing. If you go into the camera app in the photo tab, this little icon up here allows you to also change that on the go. So there's no need to adjust that in the setting application right here. Oh, volume up to burst, that's another thing. I like to leave this on. This basically allows you to take multiple shots by simply holding on the volume up like so. Scan QR codes, that's another thing. I recommend just leaving it on. This way you don't have to leave the QR code reader on the control center. You can just quickly launch the camera application. It'll be able to read the URL link just like so. Grid, this is optional. This will basically give you the rows of thirds. So if you're into that type of stuff, that's how you could enable that feature. Mirror front-facing camera. This was new for iOS 14. Basically what this allows you to do whenever you take a front-facing camera selfie, it's gonna look like exactly like how it looked like on your display in the viewfinder. So it's not gonna reverse the image. This will make sure it looks exactly the same how you took that shot. Outside the frame, turn this on. This is actually really cool. What this basically allows you to do, and you switch to the back cameras, see how the black borders are showing a live view of the other lens. So if you select like a different lens, it's gonna show you that lens in case you wanna switch to that lens. So that's basically what it does. It just always ones up the next lens, so it gives you a little preview along the borders. Leave this on, sense detection. This is basically utilizing the LiDAR sensor in the back of the iPhone 12 Pro. Same goes for the faster shooting. And then underneath that is the lens correction. Leave this on, especially if you have multiple lenses like this iPhone. And then lastly, this is just a personal trick I like to do. You know those times where you want to ask a stranger to take a photo, but you don't want them to have full access to your phone so they could look at your photo library? Well, there's a couple ways you could cleverly activate the camera application without having your device unlocked. The first method is by simply tapping the power up and down volume, and then tap the power button until you get to this screen. Hit cancel. This will disable Face ID. So now, whenever you launch the camera application, nobody's gonna have access to your full photo library that you previously captured on your iPhone. It's only gonna show the photos that was recently taken. So you can do that to disable Face ID. Another method that I like to personally do is just take your palm and just cover the front facing camera, tap on the display and just long press on the camera icon, and it will quickly just take you to the camera application. You can also just slide. But besides that, that is all the cool little nifty tricks you can do with the iPhone 12 Pro or the 11 Pro. And some of these things can still be applied even on the regular iPhone 12, which actually has a really fantastic camera. Now, if you enjoyed and you learned some cool nifty tricks, some cool features this camera array can do, greatly appreciate if you could actually leave this video a like, make sure to get subscribed. And for more iPhone hacks or cool features you could do, go ahead and check out this video over here as I go through some interesting things that you could do with Face ID. Or if you own a pair of AirPods, watch this video as I go through some hidden features you could do with that device. Anyway, folks, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll catch you all in the next one. See ya.